Good day to you. My name is Maria Kancielska and this is Pill on Daily Culture about books. And here with me in the studio is John Lynch, an entrepreneur and also a book author. Thank you very much for coming to us from Krakow.
Thank you very much. Just got here off the train a few minutes ago.
And altogether, you have your book out there, or you will have it out there just in a second.
It's almost out there. It's coming off the printing presses as we speak.
Warm pages.
Like hot bulky.
And of course, and but just before we go to this topic, and of course culture, tell us a few words about you, because of course you're American, you're an American citizen, but you're also a Polish citizen, and you feel very Polish, don't you?
Yes, actually I'm an American citizen and a Polish resident. So I have Karta Pobytu, an ID card here, and I'm living in Poland for 30 years. So this is my home, if not my nationality, although I am very proud of my association with Poland, and I do consider myself a Polish patriot.
Very nice. But you came to Poland, and this had something to do with Lech Wałęsa and his speech, as I understand.
Yeah.
Tell us more about it.
Yeah, so there was a famous, after the fall of communism and all that happened in this part of the world, Wałęsa, before he was president, had gone to U.S. Congress, made a famous speech called We the People, and he asked the U.S. Congress to send money to Poland to help get things started. And in that package, which was approved rapidly, there was money to send American business people, graduates of American business schools to Poland to help get things started over here. And I was in the first group. So I was a volunteer in 1991 to help rebuild Poland.
Very interesting. So you finished a business school, or tell us a few words about your story and then...
Yeah, sure. So I'm from New Jersey. I have Polish ancestry, so my great-grandmother was born near Białystok. Grew up in a small town in New Jersey, a place called Sayreville. After university, where I studied engineering, I worked in Philadelphia. Then I went to the Wharton School for an MBA. And after that, I was working in New York City and got a call from a professor who said, how'd you like to go to Poland? And I thought, Poland? Well, what's going on? He said, well, we've got a program to send American MBAs to Central Eastern Europe and help get capitalism started. And I stopped what I was doing and moved to Poland in August of 1991.
In the middle, I would say, of communism. I mean, the end of communism here, but a time when things were still very gray.
Yes,
and different.
Yes, it was very gray. There were still lines in the shops. We were told there were still KGB people running around. There were still 100,000 Soviet troops in Poland. So it was truly it was already after the change, but it was just at the beginning.
So lots of things were really challenging at the moment as well.
Yeah, the challenging was there, but the excitement was in the air. The entire country of Poland was kind of in a daze. Nobody could believe what happened had happened. And so there's incredible optimism in this country, which was a great thing. But the challenges were many. There was bad communications, there were not many telephones, and of course the Polish language, which was one of the biggest challenges in the beginning.
Of course, it's one of the most difficult languages in the world, and with all the flexion we have, every single ending ends itself so quickly. I can imagine it was, at the beginning, it's like, what are they saying?
Yeah, well, we had excellent language training in the States. At the University of North Carolina, Chapel Hill, we were taught by U.S. Foreign Service language instructors, and they taught us a few tricks, which was we memorized 50 sentences in Polish, you know, Dzień dobry, jestem John, things like this. And it turned out that at the typical cocktail party or social engagement, if you memorize these 50 statements, you could kind of get through the whole evening with people thinking you speak Polish fluently. So within a month, I was actually talking to people quite normally. It's remarkable.
It was remarkable. Really, then they had a trick then. They really needed to go through it and have a specialist working on it, because it's like with you know 50 sentences. It's tough.
But you know what? Think about how often when you encounter people, whether it's on a train or at a party or in a store, you only say three or four things. So those 50 sentences covered about 90% of your typical daily conversation, and we pulled it off. And people said, "How many years have you been speaking Polish?" And we said, "Just 1 month."
Wow. Well, this is actually thought-provoking when it comes to my Chinese. Maybe I just memorize 50 sentences, done.
Yes.
But you're an entrepreneur, and you started to be an entrepreneur just with your company, which is actually important when it comes to the book. Tell us a few words about the Linka.
Yeah, sure. So after the first year in Poland, I was working with Polish entrepreneurs, teaching them American marketing, finance, how to run a business. And I was watching these incredible Polish entrepreneurs building businesses from nothing. And they had no money, they had no education in business, they had no experience in what they were doing, yet there was one Polish entrepreneur after another building businesses back in those early 90s. At the end of the year, I was supposed to be here for 1 year only, I thought, am I crazy to go back to New York and jump back into the American rat race? There was more happening in Poland than anywhere else on the planet. And decided to stay and start my own company. And the company I'm still running it. It's called Linka. And it makes clothing. We probably unofficially made the first tourism t-shirts in Poland back in 1992. You know, Polska, Wawel, Krakow. And that's how the business started.
Oh, cool. So you creating clothes in Poland, which of course has something to do with your book as well.
Yeah, a little bit to do with the book. So the book, which we'll talk about more, is called The Ark. In Polish, it's called Arka, like Noah and the Ark. And it's about a young American fashion designer from the Bronx, who's from Polish roots. His parents, his father's name is Stanisław Czyż, who's translated in Ellis Island to Stanley Chase, and his son is Truman Chase. And he comes to Poland to help the family business as a fashion designer, and he achieves incredible success, only to run into a very evil hedge fund who comes along and tries to steal his business. So the book is a thriller about this young Polish-American who comes to Poland and this evil global fund who tries to steal his business and do terrible things to him. So that's the story.
And just say if you're so the Ark, and it's in the Polish and in the English version as well.
That's right. I wrote the original in English. It took me 5 years to write it. So I have a full-time job. I'm a tata, I'm a father and a husband. So I have lots of things to do. So I wrote the book on Saturday and Sunday mornings between 5 and 10 a.m. over 5 years. And about 2 years ago, I finished. I found a publisher here in Poland. I decided to publish it in Polish because this is my home. So worked with great translation team. And because I speak Polish, I was a part of the preparation of the Polish version. So the global launch of my book will be in Poland, Polish.
And we will more talk about it in the next episode. And of course, to all of you, we encourage you to go and check the book, The Art, which will be just right coming out to the bookstores. And I hope you'll enjoy the story and stay with us to the next episode to learn more.